Welcome back to another Tech Tip. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to change your screensaver. Everybody remembers the old 3D text or the 3D pipes or whatever you want to call them. Today, I'm going to actually show you how to change that to the newer stuff. Check it out. If anybody out there is new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button right below me here. Also, be sure to hit the little bell icon so you can get future notification updates. We do a lot of how-tos, a lot of tutorials, videos just like this one. So I'm on Windows 10, so the directions are going to be a little bit different than if you were on, like, say, Windows 7 or Windows Vista, but it's going to be very similar. And what you're going to do is you're going to right-click anywhere on the desktop, no matter what operating system you have. And then for Windows 7 and Windows Vista users, you're going to go ahead and click on the setting that says Display Settings. And that'll bring up a little menu that you'll see. We'll come back to that in just a moment. But for Windows 10 users and Windows 8 and 8.1, go ahead and click on Personalize. Then you're going to get a little menu here on the left-hand side. You're going to have a list of different things. You're going to want to go ahead and click Themes, or I'm sorry, go ahead and click Lock Screen. And it's going to bring up some other settings. In the middle, at the very bottom, you're going to want to click on Screen Saver Settings. Go ahead and left-click on that. Now, this is the window that's going to pop up whether you're on Windows 10, Windows 7, Windows Vista. You're going to get this little window right here. And this is what allows you to go in and change your screensaver and modify the settings of each one. So as you can see right now, I have it set on ribbons. If I click on the settings, it's going to tell me that there's no additional settings for this specific screensaver. So let's go ahead and take a look at the list. Yours may be different. You may have a few other options, a few less options, but these are just different types of screensavers that you can set onto the computer. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and go from the ribbons. I'm going to go to the 3D text. And you'll get a little preview here. And then if you click on settings, this will allow you to go in and really customize what you want that screensaver to do. So what you want it to say, what kind of font, you know, your spin, if you want it to rotate, spin, I think bounce or wobble. So you can see there's different options in there. Solid, texture, colors, you can change the color on it. And then of course you can go in and change the resolution, size, rotation speed. Once you've got all that set up, just go ahead and click OK. And it will apply those settings right here. And then if you wanted to go in and change it again, you just come back to this and you can change. So if we wanted to go to Photos, we can click on Settings. And then if we click Browse, this will allow you to search your computer for the different types of photos that you're wanting to display as your screensaver. And then, of course, you can change the speed of it. You can shuffle the picture so it's not in a set rotation. Once you've got that, again, go ahead and click on Save. And then before you close out this menu, you'll want to click Apply and then OK. And what that's going to do is that's going to finalize that screensaver. Just to kind of go over the directions one more time, right-click anywhere on the screensaver. If you're on Windows 7 or Vista, click on Display Settings. If you're on Windows 8 and up, click on Personalize. Come on over here to Lock Screen. And then once again down here at the bottom, go ahead and click Screensaver Settings. And then this little box will pop up and you can go in and change it from there.
Hey guys, thanks for watching that tech tip video. Just a quick question of the day before you go. What do you do to your computer to help customize it or to make it yours? Leave your answer in the comment section below. And also while you're down there, make sure to hit the subscribe button and also hit the little bell icon to make sure that you receive any kind of future notifications for when we put out new content. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.